I would like to take everyone on a field trip, really. They're very badly managed and run. None of them are sanitary landfills. They're all the waste disposal sites, the government calls them. I call them dumps.
Almost 1 year ago, February 6, 2012 to be exact, toxic fumes bellowed from the country's largest waste disposal site, Riverton. Diana McCauley, Chief Executive Officer of the Jamaica Environment Trust, has been a staunch critic of the operations at the site.
And you know, last year when the dump burned, Riverton burned, all those images were all over TV, you know, the disease vectors, the animals, the, you know, things being dumped there with people sorting through them in bare hands, very poor working conditions.
Spearheaded by the Ministry of Local Government and Community Development, Ministry of Health, and the Ministry of Water, Land, Environment and Climate Change, emergency teams responded to the crisis. What has been done since then?
I'm really disappointed in what's happened since the major fire in February 2012.
All the authorities agree, we have a problem at Riverton. Something needs to be done. In response to this recent incident that left the country with a huge bill and many residents in the surrounding communities suffering from respiratory illnesses because of the adverse effects of the smoke, lobby groups again pushed for something to be done. The authorities established an interministerial group.
There is a waste management committee, which is a subset of the interministerial committee. And the interministerial committee is showing the highest level of accountability and responsibility the government is taking for what happened. Now, the waste management committee is in a way is to operationalize the thinking of the ministers. And the waste management committee is a fairly large committee. It has a number of government ministries and agencies. We have a little setback because we had to clarify and sort out some domestic issues related to how we'd proceed. But we have convened at least four meetings, to deal with the issues.
I met in roughly August of 2012, and there was a decision that we had to look back through all the studies and reports and papers that have been done over the years, because you understand this is not a problem that has come up recently. It's a very, very long-standing. And then the committee, we were supposed to get a report. It was being coordinated by the Planning Institute. We were supposed to get a report saying what was the situation, the status of waste management in Jamaica. We got that report, and I have to say I really have not seen those action points. And I'm not even sure if any steps have been taken at the Riverton dump to improve the situation and what those steps are.
In order to implement the needed changes at Riverton, the NSWMA needs an environmental permit.
The then Ministry of Local Government and Community Development in 2004 did obtain an environmental permit from the Natural Resources Conservation Authority. Unfortunately, it wasn't operationalized. They have now made an application. They have made many attempts, and it didn't meet our requirements. We have sat with them, and we have resolved those issues. So the application is now accepted. We are now consulting. We are now reviewing the application, but we are also consulting with the key government referral agencies, the Ministry of Health, the Water Resources Authority, and the National Works Agency. As you know, they are critical to the development approval process. I can't give a timeline when it will go to the technical review committee.
With the country experiencing tight fiscal constraints, how much more can be invested in Riverton? The fire last year cost the government approximately $60 million, and resources have already been wasted in the past. An Inter-American Development Bank loan was cancelled in 2007 after only a quarter of it was invested after being signed in 1999.
Money has been spent on the dump, and things have been done out there which have been allowed to fall into, you know, disuse and disrepair, and then essentially meaning the money was wasted.
But what would an ideal solid waste management site look like?
A properly managed sanitary landfill would first of all be lined. It would be lined by something like a big plastic, a big sheet of plastic. Think about how garbage breaks down, you know, it produces a liquid. And that liquid leaches into rivers or groundwater or the sea, and it's a pollutant. And then you would have a mechanism for taking off that leachate and treating it. It also, as garbage breaks down, it makes gases. You'd also have a mechanism for taking those gases off. And then what would happen is the garbage would come to a so-called cell, well, just an area of the dump, which is the area that they're working on, and then it would be covered at the end of the day by dirt, construction material, so it wouldn't burn.
Environmentalists believe that the challenges at Riverton are just symptomatic of an overall challenge with solid waste management. Just recently, garbage was piling up all over the city.
It's not so much that we don't have enough trucks. You know, you hear that, you know, there's a shortage of trucks. But the problem is that a lot of them are off the road at any given time. It's a maintenance problem. So if we're having this major maintenance problem, what are the solutions for that?
The solution does not rest with the state alone.
Well, essentially, you'd have some separation at source. So that means the average householder would not send just all their garbage, you know, all put together to the dump. So we all have responsibility. We have personal responsibility for how we handle our waste. But also the government has a responsibility to provide waste management facilities. And I don't think either is happening.
Private investors have expressed interest about establishing a power plant for generating renewable energy. But those discussions are ongoing.
So authorities continue to meet and to plan. Environmentalists are anxious for speedy implementation.
Yeah, I certainly think we have the capacity. I mean, I don't think operating a solid waste system is beyond us at all. I wonder about the will. Time to time, we'd like to ask you.